Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you are good and safe. Welcome to today's class. So today we will start a new chapter, chapter 7, working with QBasic. So first you should know what is QBasic. So QBasic is a programming language mainly used to write programs. So that is QBasic language. And these topics we will cover in this chapter. First introduction, second starting QBasic, third format of QBasic statements, fourth elements of QBasic, fifth keywords, and sixth QBasic statements. So welcome to today's class. First topic is introduction. Introduction about QBasic. QBasic is a programming language mainly used for writing programs. So that is QBasic language. Okay, how it will work? So it reads every line and translates it. Okay, that is the working of QBasic. It translates, it reads every line and translates it. Then computer executes line by line. Okay, understood? And one thing more, the full form of QBasic is like in QBasic, Q stands for quick and basic stands for beginners all purpose symbolic instruction code. That is the full form of QBasic. Okay, next, how can we start QBasic? Okay, so for starting of QBasic, we have to follow some steps. Step 1, search QBasic icon on desktop. If it is already on your desktop, so search QBasic icon on your desktop. Otherwise, search by qbasic.exe file. Okay, so that step you have to follow. Then step 2, if you have already found on your desktop, search on your desktop, then double click on the QBasic icon. Okay, on double clicking on QBasic icon, so this window will appear on your screen. So that is QBasic window. Okay, so first one contains three buttons, that is minimize, maximize, and close button. Close button will be used to close up QBasic window, maximize to open it on a large space. So that will be as maximize. In a more maximum size, we can see this window. And minimize to hide that window. So that are the three buttons. Okay. Next bar is known as menu bar because it contains many menus that will be used for different purposes. So like file, added user. So this bar is known as menu bar. And then come to the last bar is known as status bar. It shows different status of your working. Here and this and shows status of new log. New log will be used to type numbers. Okay, 001 shows current row number and 00 here. This one shows current column number. Current row number and current column number. And this box is known as welcome dialog box. Whenever you open two basic window, so automatically that dialog box will open. Okay, so it shows welcome to MS DOS two basic. Okay, so for writing your program, you have to close this dialog box. So you have to press accept key. You have to press accept key to close this dialog box. Whenever you will press accept key, so automatically that dialog box will close or disappear, you can say. So you will get blank space or area to type your programs. Okay. Next topic is format of QBasic statements. So before format, we should discuss about statements. What are statements? So every instruction or commands is known as statements. Okay. So next we have to discuss format of QBasic statements. Means how, what is the format of QBasic statement? So for writing any statement, we need a syntax. Okay. Just like in your English language, na, a structure will be there to write a sentence like object, subject, helper, main verb, like this. And your maths also, na, a formula is there to put that values in that formula and you will get the result. So like that, here in this we will use a syntax. Okay, with the help of syntax, we are able to write the program. Okay. So QBasic statements have a syntax. So So first we should know what is syntax. So syntax means specifics. The specific set of rules for writing statements is called syntax. Specific rules, set of which we can say. So that is known as syntax. Okay. Next topic is elements of cube basic. Elements of cube basic. So they overall in a cube basic many elements are there, but we are generally discussing here three elements. So first is character set. Second is consonant and third is value. So what is character set? So a set of symbols used to frame the various components of a program. So that is known as character set. Okay, understood? There are three values in character set, like letters, letters from A to Z. Okay, then digits, digits from 0 to 9, and special symbols. Special symbols like addition, subtraction, multiplication, exponential. So that are the special symbols. So it contains three values or three sets of values. Okay, letter, digit, and special symbols. Then next is consonant. So what are consonants? So though the data whose values cannot be changed or fixed, that is known as consonant. So that values are known as consonant. Means values cannot be changed, that are fixed during the program execution, so that are known as consonants. Okay. Next is variable. So consonant is of two types. Okay, numeric consonant and alphanumeric consonant. Numeric consonant contains the values in numbers only. Okay, and alphanumeric, so the values which may be in integer or in numeric form and alphabetical also. It contains alphabets also. So that is the form of alphanumeric, means mixture of alphabet and number. So that is known as alphanumeric. Okay, understood? Like I want to write computer 1, 2, 3. So it is a combination of alphabets and numbers. So that is known as alphanumeric. So consonant is of two types, numeric consonant and alphanumeric consonant. Okay. Next is variable. What are variables? The values that can be changed according to our need during the program execution. So that values are known as variable, that can be changed. Okay, understood? So that are variables. Variables also of two types, numeric variable and alphanumeric variable. Okay, so these are the three elements of QBasic. Understood? Next topic is keywords. So what are keywords? So keywords are the reserved words that have special meaning, and cannot be used for any other purpose in the program. So that words are known as keywords, means reserved words that will be used for a specific purpose and that cannot be used for any other purpose. So that are known as keywords. Keywords like if, and if, else if. So that will be used for a specific purpose. So that words are known as keywords. If, and if, else if, what if. So that are keywords. Okay. Next is QBasic statements. So many QBasic statements are there, but we are generally discussing four statements because these are important for us. Others also important for us, but here we will discuss only four. Okay. First is CLS statements. So CLS statements are used for clear the screen, clear the output of the screen. It is meant for clear screen, means to clear the screen. Whatever you have written, when you press, when you will use CLS statement, all the written work will be erased or clear. So that is the use of CLS statement. It clears the output and make it blank. It clears whatever you have written and make it blank. Okay, that is the use of CLS statement. Next is LAMP statement. As it is shown here, LAMP will be used for writing any kind of remark. So that is LAMP statement. So it is used to add comments, or we can say remark, in the body of the program. The body of the program is in the program, we can say. So that is LAMP statement. Okay, understood? Syntax, RAM, every variable you have to write in a capital letter or in a block letter in a two basis. Otherwise, it will not accept. So RAM, that remark here, whatever remark you want to give here. Okay? Understood? Like example, we can say RAM, find the area of circle. You can write RAM here and brackets, find the area of circle. So that means the remark or comment of for your program. Okay, in this way you have to write the program. Understood? Next is print. Print the statement print. By the word you can understand, it displays or get prints of your program. So it displays the output of your program on the screen. Whatever the output you have typed, so it displays the output of your program on the screen. That is the working of print display. Okay? Understood? But it displays only on the screen, not on the paper. Okay? Syntax. Print EXP. EXP here, EXP means any kind of expression you have written. Like, say for example we can say print expression, which means we can give any kind of expression like enjoy learning. So print enjoy learning. So this is the example of print statement. Okay. Next is let. What is that? So let is used for assigning values, to give values. So that is the use of let. So it is used to assign values to a variable. Values to a variable. Okay, it is used to assign values to a variable. Like syntax, let var. Var means here variable. So variable values we can give like numbers, like any kind of word or alphabetical order we can give, alphabets we can give. So we can give values in a numeric form also or in a alphanumeric form also. So it is up to us. Example we can say let var like equal to p equal to 2 or p equal to 12. So that kind of values we can give by the let statement. Or we can assign the values by the let statements. Okay, so these are the two basic statements. Okay, so your chapter 7 is completed here. Thank you everyone.